Now let's see about bus and memory transfers. First let's see the advantage of bus. In a programming language, let us assume that we want to execute a statement like b is equal to a, but internally the variables are represented in the form of registers. So let b is represented in the form of R2, whereas a is represented in the form of R1. So we know the advantage of b is equal to a. The contents of a, the value of a will be assigned to b. So in register transfer, we use a CRO operator, replacement operator. So whenever the statement is executed, then the contents of register R1 will be transferred to register R2. Assumes that the size of register is 8 bits. So what is the size of R1? R1 size is 8 bits. So we can have 8 bits from 0 to 7. So likewise R2 size is also 8 bits. This is R2. So we can have 8 bits from 0 to 7. So in order to transfer the contents from R1 to R2, here we need to have 8 cables or 8 wires. So we need to have 8 cables. So with the help of these 8 cables, the contents of R1 will be transferred to R2. Let us assume that size of the register is 32 bits. Then how many cables are needed? Then 32 cables are needed in order to transfer the contents of R1 to R2. Assumes that our system contains 100 registers. So now from each register, we have to establish connections to remaining all other registers. So from register 1 to remaining 99 registers, we need to establish some cables, some connections. Next, from register 2 remaining 99 registers, we need to establish connections with the help of cables or wires. So what is the problem with this approach? We need to have thousands of cables, we need to have lakhs of cables in order to maintain the connections from one register to remaining all registers in the system. So this is very expensive process. Too many cables or wires are needed. We can overcome this problem with the help of common bus system, with the help of bus. So bus is mainly useful in order to transfer information from one register to another register in a less expensive manner. Okay. Here we can implement the common bus system in two approaches. The first approach is using multiplexers. The second approach is using decoders with three-state buffer or tri-state buffer. In this video, we will discuss the first approach, how to implement the bus with the help of multiplexers, whereas in the next video we will see how to implement bus with the help of decoders and three-state buffer. Assumes that we have four registers, register A, register B, register C and register D, where the size of each register is 4 bits. So register A stores 4 bits of data from 0 to 3, register B stores 4 bits of data from 0 to 3, like that. Next, we need to have four multiplexers. The number of multiplexers depends upon the number of registers. If there are four registers, then we need to have four multiplexers. Then what is the size of each register? The size of each register is 4 bits. So the size of each multiplexer is also 4 bits. We know the advantage of a multiplexer. Multiplexer accepts n selection lines. So n selection lines are to be applied to the multiplexers. If there are n selection lines, then 2 power inputs are applied to the multiplexer. If there are 2 power inputs, then it produces only 1 output. If you take any multiplexer, then it produces only 1 output. So out of available 2 power n inputs, it selects 1 input and it produces the corresponding output. Okay. So if there are 2 selection lines, then 2 power 2, that means 4 inputs are needed. If there are 3 selection lines, then 2 power 3, that is nothing but 8 inputs are needed. In this example, we have 4 inputs are there. So we need to have 2 selection lines. Let selection lines are denoted by S1 and S0. So S1 and S0 should be applied to all the multiplexers. So this is nothing but S1 selection line. This is nothing but S0 selection line, which is applied on multiplexer 0. So this is multiplexer 0, multiplexer 1, multiplexer 2, multiplexer 3. The size of each multiplexer is 4 bits. And what is the size here? 4 by 1. So 4 by 1 means it accepts 4 inputs and produces 1 output. Next, this is nothing but S1 selection line is applied to the multiplexer 1, S0 selection line is applied to multiplexer 1, S1 selection line applied on multiplexer 2, S0 selection line applied on multiplexer 2, S1 and S0 selection lines are applied on multiplexer 3. Next, here each multiplexer receives input from resistors. Let's see how the inputs will be supplied. Here, register A contains 4 bits, likewise each register contains 4 bits. The 0 output of all the registers should be supplied as input to the multiplexer 0. So, multiplexer 0, input 0, receives input from register 0, register A, output 0. So, likewise, multiplexer 0, input 1, receives input from register B, output 0. So here the point is, multiplexer 0 receives input from output 0 of all the registers. So this register A, 0 input, 0 output will be supplied as input to multiplexer 0, 0 input. Here for each register we have 4 bits. So 4 into 4 means 16. So 16 connections are needed. If you place all those 16 connections, then the diagram will become too complex. So that's why let us show connections for only one register. Let us show the connection for register D. And for all the connections, we are showing some labels. Let it be some A0. So this A0 will be supplied as input to register 0. Likewise, register B, output 0, will be supplied as input to, so which register? Multiplexer 0, output 1. So this is, what is the label here? B0 is the label. So likewise, register 0, output 0, will be supplied as input to, multiplexer 0, input 2, okay? So what is the label here? Here the label is C0. So it will get the input from C0. So likewise, this is nothing but D0. So D0, this D0 will be supplied as input to the input 3 of multiplexer 0. So likewise, multiplexer 1 receives input from output 1 of all the registers. So this register A, 1 input, 1 output, output 1 will be supplied as input to this multiplexer 1, 0 input. So this is nothing but A1. Next, what is this one? Register B, output 1 will be supplied as input to this multiplexer 1, B1. So next, this is nothing but C1. So this C1 should be passed as input to this input 2. Next, this is nothing but D1. So D1 will be passed as output to this multiplexer 1 input. Okay. Next one, multiplexer 2. Multiplexer 2 receives input from output 2 of all the registers. So let it be A2. So we have to pass A2 as input to this multiplexer 2, 0 input. Next, this is nothing but B2. So B2 should be passed as input to this 1. So this is nothing but C2. So C2 will be passed as input to this 2. Next, this is nothing but D2. So D2 should be passed as input to this connection. Now let us draw the physical connections for multiplexer 3. So multiplexer 3 receives input from output 3 of all the registers. Okay. So this 3 will be passed as input to this 3. Next, this 2. It will get the input from register C, third output. Next, it will get the input from register B, third output. Next, it will get input from register A, last output. Okay. So likewise, the connections can be made. Let us assume that here the selection lines are 0, 0. If the selection lines are 0, 0, then each multiplexer produces this 0 bit as the output. If the selection lines are 0, 1, then the multiplexer produces this 1 as the output. Let us assume that the selection lines are 0, 0. So what is S1, S0? S1, S0 is 0, 0. So if 0, 0 is applied on the multiplexer, then multiplexer 0 will produce 0 as the output. Then multiplexer 1 also produces 0 as the output. Next, multiplexer 2 also produces 0 as the output. Next, multiplexer 3 also produces 0 as the output. So it produces the 0. What is the 0? A0 as the output. So what is 0 here? A1 as the output. What is 0 here? A2 as the output. What is 0 here? A3 as the output. So A0, A1, A2, A3 are nothing but register A bits. What is register A? 0 bit is nothing but A0. 1 means A1, 2 means A2, 3 means A3. So register A information will be placed on the bus. So likewise, so which information will be placed? Register A information will be placed on the bus. Likewise, if the selection inputs are 0, 1, then each multiplexer produces this 1 as the output. So multiplexer 0 produces this 1 as the output. So what is this 1? B0. Next, multiplexer 1 produces this 1 as the output. What is this 1? It is getting input from B1. So B1, this multiplexer produces B2 as the output. What is this 1? B2. This multiplexer produces this 1 as the output. So what is this 1? B3. So B0, B1, B2, B3 are nothing but the contents of register B. So register B information will be placed on the bus. So if the inputs are 0, 1, then register B information will be placed. If the selection inputs are 1, 0, then register C information will be placed. If the selection inputs are 1, 1, then register D information will be placed on the bus. So once the information is available in the bus, then the output of the bus has to be connected to the input to the destination register. So here, why we are using bus? In order to transfer the contents from one register to the another register. Let us assume that we want to transfer the content from C to the R1. So we want to transfer the contents from C register to the R1 register. So for that, first this C information has to be placed on the bus. Next, that bus transfers the contents of C to R1 register. So how C information will be placed on the bus? If you select the selection lines 1, 0, if you select 1, 0, then every multiplexer produces 2 as the output. So 2 is nothing but C0, C1, C2, C3. So C information will be placed on the bus. So now the output of the bus should be connected as input to the register R1. So if output of bus is connected as input to the register R1, then bus contains the C information only. So that C information will be that C information will be transferred to the R1. So in this way, we can transfer the contents of one register to another register with the help of a bus. Now let's see what is memory transfer. Here mainly two operations are there. First operation is read operation. Second operation is write operation. So read means transferring the data from memory to any register. If we transfer the data from memory to any register, then it is called as read operation. Here M stands for memory, AR stands for address register. So let it be some instruction register. Here it may be any register. Okay. Here this destination may be any register. It may be some instruction register or index register or index sequential register, any register. So read operation means transferring the data from memory to any register. Here we are representing memory with the help of M of AR. AR represents address register, M represents the value at the memory register. And we have one more operation, that is write operation. So write means transferring the data from any register to the memory. So what is write? So write means transferring the data from any register to the memory. So M of AR, ARO, IR. So now the data of instruction register will be transferred to the memory. This operation is called as write operation. Whereas transferring the data from memory to any register is called as read operation. So mainly we can perform these two transfers from memory to any register or from register to any memory. So this is about implementation of common bus system using multiplexers. In the next video, we will discuss about how to implement common bus system with the help of three-state bus buffer and decoders.